Hello folks, welcome back. So I want to introduce the concept of energy payback time in this for photovoltaic systems in this video. And since I'm an engineer and engineers love three and four lettered acronyms, so I can abbreviate this energy payback time as EPBT or energy payback time. And the definition of this energy payback time is essentially contained in the title itself. So what it represents or what it means is the amount of time which is required to pay back or recover the amount of energy which was used to make the solar panel or the module in the first place. So I can express this mathematically as this EPBT or energy payback time. It's essentially equal to the amount of energy which was required to make the solar cells, divided by the rate at which the solar cell or module is producing this energy. So this energy payback time is essentially given by this formula, which is essentially the amount of energy which was used to make this solar module. And I can also write this as the specific energy of my solar module. So it's the specific energy of my solar module divided by the rate at which my solar module is producing or generating electricity. So my energy payback time or EPBT, I can represent it by this formula. And further, I'm plotting over here, or I'm borrowing this chart from NREL, or National Renewable Energy Lab, which has projected and plotted these energy payback time for both multicrystalline and thin film based solar technologies. So what these report, which was released in 2001, it says that these solar modules, which are made of multicrystalline or single crystalline based solar cells, they have a energy payback time of 3.8 years. And the solar cells or solar modules, which are made using thin film based technologies, they have an energy payback time of 3 years. And you might think, that 3 years is a very long time. I'm making a solar module and over 3 years to recover the amount of energy which was just used to make the solar panel. But it's exactly not. I mean, if we need to contrast this 3 years with the lifetime of these solar modules. So usually these solar panels, they have come with a rated lifetime of 30 years. And what this number is saying, that you can recover back the amount of energy which was required to produce this solar cell or this solar module in 3 years. So for the remaining 27 years, we are essentially in energy positive, or we are net positive in the amount of energy that is being produced by this solar module. Another way to look at this number is essentially, you require 3 years to recover back the energy which was used to make this solar panels. So as compared to the lifetime of this solar module, it's producing nine times. So 27 divided by 3, it's producing 9 times the energy which was required to make this solar module. Since it's we are assuming that this solar module will continue to work for 30 years, and it might continue to work even longer, but just to take a conservative number. So it's producing 9 times the energy which was required to make or produce this solar module. So the next thing I want to bring to your attention is that how these energy payback time, it compares for multicrystalline and thin film solar technology. So this report, which was released by NREL, it says that the multicrystalline based crystalline based solar cells, they have an energy payback time of 3 years, and thin film based solar cells are actually better. And I find it surprising, and I'll just tell you why I find it surprising. But what is even more surprising, or even more interesting, is that going forward, or looking into the future, what this report or this report by NREL anticipated is that multicrystalline-based solar cell will have going forward. So going looking into the future, the energy payback time of a multicrystalline-based solar cell will reduce from 3 years to reduce to 3 years to approximately 2 years. So why would this energy payback time reduce? And the answer is essentially contained in this formula. So going forward, what you can anticipate is that the amount of energy which will be required to make this solar module or solar panel will decrease, because we'll become more and more efficient in making these solar panels. At the same time, the energy or the efficiencies sorry the efficiency of these solar panels will increase. So the rate at which these solar panels are generating electricity will increase. So the energy payback time it's supposed to degrade, or it's supposed to decrease as we look into the future. But the thing I find surprising is that these thin film based solar modules, these are anticipated to become even better. So these thin film based solar modules, they are anticipated to have a energy payback time for 1 year. So in little more than a year, you can recover all the amount of energy which was spent to making these thin film based solar cells. And if they have a lifetime of 30 years, for the rest of the 29 years, you are net positive in the amount of energy, total energy spent. So the why do I find these this trend or this comparison between multicrystalline and thin film based solar cell surprising? So the reason I find this surprising, or unexpected, is because the efficiencies of thin film based solar panels are much smaller as compared to multicrystalline based solar cells. So roughly the efficiency of these thin film based solar panels, they are half the efficiency of what you get in a multicrystalline based solar panels. So just to give you some estimate, I'll assume a efficiency of 6% for a thin film based solar module, and for a single crystalline or multicrystalline based solar modules, I expect efficiency of twice of what I get for my thin film. So I'll expect a efficiency of 12%. And these are pretty conservative numbers for efficiency of these modules, but I want to use them anyway to give you a feel of the topic. So now I have the efficiency of thin film as a thin film based module as 6%. So what is the rate at which it generates energy, or what is the amount of energy it generates per year? And I can calculate that essentially equal to that is equal to the efficiency of my solar module multiplied by the incoming solar radiation, or the solar insolation, which is the amount of radiation which is incoming per year per meter square of area. And this incoming solar radiation or insolation is typically a number which is taken to be 1700 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. The US average is slightly higher than this, actually 1800 kilowatt hour per meter square per year, but this is the number which is most commonly touted about or cited in literature. So I'll just use this to calculate the amount of energy that these different modules are generating per year, and then I'll use my energy payback time. My energy payback time to give me an estimate of the amount of energy which was required to actually make these solar cells. So let's essentially fill up this table. So for my thin film based solar module, I have an efficiency of 6%. So the amount of energy that I'll be generating per year is essentially equal to 0.06 multiplied by 1700, and this essentially gives me 17 into 6 is 102. So this gives me 102 kilowatt hour per meter square per year. So that is the amount of energy that I'll be generating per year in 1 meter square of area. And since single crystalline based solar cells have a twice the efficiency of that, so they'll be essentially generating 204 kilowatt hour of energy per meter square per year. And now what I'm anticipating is that my thin film based solar cells, they have an energy payback time of 1 year, and these single crystalline based or multicrystalline based solar cells, they have an energy payback time anticipated of 2 years. So now my energy, which is essentially required to make these cells, was my energy payback time multiplied by the rate at which I'm generating this multiplied by the rate at which I'm generating this energy. That comes from, again, the way I define my energy payback time. So my energy payback time was essentially E divided by this E dot. So E, or the amount of energy which is required to make this solar cell, is my energy payback time multiplied by the rate at which I am generating this electricity from this module. So now my energy which is required to make this thin film based module is essentially equal to this 102 into 1 year. So this will give me a number of this will give me essentially 102 kilowatt hour. So this is the energy which was required to make 1 meter square of this thin film module. Now the thing I'm surprised by is that crystalline based solar cell, it has a much higher efficiency. That's it's generating a much higher rate electricity at a much higher rate, and but still it has a much higher it has twice the energy payback time. What it means is that the energy which is required now to, which was estimated to make this solar panel, is essentially given by this generation rate multiplied by this energy payback time. So this is 204 multiplied by 2. So this would be 408 kilowatt hour per meter square. So what is surprising is that the amount of energy which is required to make these single crystalline based solar panel is essentially 4x amount of energy which was required to make this thin film based solar module. So even though this energy payback, this rate of generating this energy is twice, or this efficiency of single crystalline cell is twice of is twice of what you get for a thin film, but still, it because of this high amount or 4 times higher energy required, the single crystalline based solar cell, it still takes twice the amount of time to pay back this energy. And I'll discuss in the next video why this is the case.